I'll just hold it. All right. This poem's called Thinking of Jesus. The other day I was thinking of Jesus and whether or not he knew that Muhammad was coming. And if he did, whether or not he'd draw pictures of him. And if he did, whether or not there'd be religion to follow him. What if Jesus met Muhammad with the sword in between them, with the will of their gods resting easy upon them? Could they be conscious of the legacies that each would leave? And if they were, could they ever find a way to teach that would resonate so deep within humanity that our way of life would slowly shift from war to peace? And I can't help but think about the violence in the Middle East and how it never seems to cease. Like the legitimacy for revenge is on the increase. A society of war when it can live through the bombing. See, heavy hits the switch and the payload's unleashed. He's got a picture of his ma with the cross beneath. He swears to God if it takes his whole life, he'll take out all these beasts. Human targets labeled terrorists, soulless enemies, or so he believed. But did Jesus preach a life of dropping bombs for peace? Did he not say to love thine enemy? I think I remember something of a holy trinity. And if you would, please, I'd like to share with you a very short story. It's about our father, who spent most of his life doing art in heaven, painting rosebuds out of raindrops, dripping light rays onto cloud tops. Oh, hallowed be his name. I hope I live to see the day when his kingdom come. But for now, all I seem to see is his work undone. And what would Jesus think if he knew we'd given up on making earth as it is in heaven? Would he even give us our daily bread? And how many times are we going to make him come back and die to save our lives? He's still got to forgive us our trespasses, but not till we forgive those who have trespassed against us. But right now, I feel we're falling victim to temptation. And every day on earth, humans commit pure evil to feast on the power of dark glory, void of spirit, forever and ever. So help them, God. But right now, I'm talking about Jesus and Muhammad, searching for peace in the rubble of a freedom speech, trying to make a puzzle out of a world already bombed to pieces. And the politicians speak of justice and mention liberty, and the rhetoric all sounds like election year doublespeak. And if you want to know what's happening, you can follow the money. But it's plain and clear to see that this world is very ripe for another land of liberty. Only this time, let us plant it in our hearts. For there, it will always be free. For there, it remains out of reach of all the dark souls who would ever care to break it. Bury the hatchet in the sand so the blade will never make it through the tree of life. Dull the blade that would swing at liberty, would sacrifice humanity, would slice through the heartfelt melodies of the beautiful songs we sing in deep mourning. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like